So, Nick, there's three main pillars to the Fleet Strategy 2012 for SEAT. Could you explain what they are?
Sure. Three key pillars of the strategy. The first one is to raise our awareness within the fleet and business sales marketplace, and also increase our image. We ultimately want to be on the consideration list for both fleets and local businesses, but also user choosers moving forward. So we recognise that the way to achieve that is by increasing our overall awareness and at the same time improving our brand image here in the UK.
So is the biggest challenge to actually get onto the fleet list first off, or is it to actually raise that awareness with the drivers so that once you're on the list, they select you?
I think it's a bit of both. We want to raise ourselves in terms of consideration levels from fleet and business decision makers, but also just as importantly is are the user chooser drivers in the marketplace. And we're very clear how we're going to do that, which is a significant investment in our marketing communication over the course of the next 3 years, focused on the fleet and business sales marketplace.
Mm-hmm. So in what sort of way will you be addressing the marketing and awareness? Through what channels will that take place?
Well, we'll certainly have a basic medial presence in terms of above-the-line communication, in terms of the national press. Obviously, titles like yourself will benefit from that moving forward. But we also see online and the web as a core part of our communication strategy moving forward. Specifically, we are currently developing the Fleet website to be more user-friendly, more informative, and to enable our communication both with decision-makers and user-chooser drivers to be industry-leading. Overall investment in the web and online marketing, again, is part of our key strategy moving forward. So you'll start to see SEAT's presence in the online marketplace much more than what you've seen previously.
And what sort of message will you be putting across to the fleets, and will that message vary depending on whether you're talking to large fleets, small fleets, public sector, leasing companies?
The key message will be themed around head meets heart. SEAT have a fantastic product range which satisfies both the decisions that you make with the head and those decisions that you make with the heart. We have an excellent Ecomotive range with the Ibiza and the Leon currently, which will be expanded next year into the Altea range. Great whole life cost messages, fantastic environmental messages. In terms of the key messages, then the messages will be underpinned that the SEAT product range is both a product range that you can choose with your head, but also choose with your heart. Mm-hmm. Ecomotive are our industry-leading models that deliver an excellent environmental message. For example, the Ibiza Ecomotive has a CO2 emissions of 98 grams. Early part of next year, you'll see the Leon Ecomotive moving from 119 CO2 to again under 100 at 99 grams with the introduction of start-stop technology. But at the other end of the scale, we have the FR range and also the Cooper range, which really are choices made on emotion, and that's certainly at the core of the SEAT brand.
So another key pillar is the sales volume. Which parts of the fleet market do you see as offering the greatest opportunity?
We see all channels within the fleet and business sales market as an opportunity, both for ourselves and our dealer network. But in terms of priority, we recognise that the leasing companies and the leasing industry certainly take the majority of fleet funding in the UK currently, and that's where our priority will focus on at the start in terms of the leasing companies. And that's very much about ensuring that our strong whole life cost message is reflected in leasing company rates, And as a result of that, we then appeal to the widest choice of company car drivers as possible. But that isn't to say we're going to ignore those companies who continue to outright purchase their cars and all channels within the fleet and business sales market.
Mm-hmm. So the message with leasing companies about the whole life cost message, are you then relying on leasing companies to do the sell for you to fleets, or how would that relationship work?
We have a team of four area managers, area fleet managers that will cover the UK, and each of the area managers will have responsibility for a group of leasing companies within their mm-hmm. territory. And I think they should both complement each other. If we can get the positioning right of SEAT from a whole life cost perspective on the leasing company's books, then that's the foundation that we need to achieve. And then we can enhance that by the sales focus of the area manager team, working very closely with their individual leasing companies to exploit any opportunities that are developed throughout the course of the year.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And the third pillar that you're focusing on?
Third pillar is very much about improving the customer experience. We recognise that if we can deliver an excellent customer experience, that we will ultimately improve customer loyalty. And it remains a key focus area for us moving forward. We will enhance the customer experience partly because we've invested heavily in a new fleet field team, mm-hmm. but we're also investing in a new fleet business centre. The business centre will be an extension of that field team, and we'll be able to provide a level of service to customers that most customers will expect as the norm today. So communication will be improved, delivery of information, simple things like the organising and booking of demonstrators will come from the Fleet Business Centre, mm-hmm. As well as targeting customers that we've not yet currently got a relationship with.
Okay, and the business centre is likely to go live at which time?
We're currently in the middle of a tender process. It is our intention that the Fleet Business Centre goes live from the beginning of next year. At the moment, we're on track for that. But as you can appreciate, we've not made that final decision at mm-hmm. the moment.
And will the business centre be speaking to a particular type of fleet, the smaller fleets, larger fleets, or again, is it across the board? It's just another layer of communication?
It will be across the board, but the key focus for the business centre is to speak to companies who are running more than 25 vehicles. Mm-hmm. 25 vehicles upwards is very much where we see our core area of opportunity. But through that communication, of course, they will come across local businesses that they can refer through to our dealer network.